That's my younger brother, Drew. There's nothing worse than having a little brother that's bigger than you.
Keisha was the girl next door. At 13, I didn't know a lot about sex, but I knew she had something to do with it.
Hey, Drew.
Drew?
What's up, Keisha?
You know her?
Yeah.
Drew was so cool, he got girls at 10 that I couldn't get until I was 30.
After I helped Drew with his math, his score changed by a whole grade.
A D? Chris, he got a C before. I thought I told you to help him. I didn't.
So, you moved the decimal point over two places. Hey, which one you like better? The spider web or the stepladder?
Is Drew stupid?
No, I'm not stupid, you idiot.
What? This looks like...
Hey. Nobody is stupid.
Drew got a D on his math test.
Shut up.
A D?
You shut up.
Chris, I thought you were gonna help.
I did.
Tanya said she was telling, that meant I was getting in trouble. But I didn't care. All I wanted to do was slap the black off of Drew.
What happened?
Looks like the older brother came home, found little brother kissing his woman, and slapped the black off him.
Is this the black?
All we could find.
So much for brotherly love.
What's wrong with you?
What?
You knew I liked Keisha. Now you're up here kissing her?
I didn't even know you liked her. And besides, I wasn't kissing her. She was kissing me.
He used that same excuse with a woman's husband 10 years later, and it worked.
Hey, Chris.
What?
I'm sorry about that girl, Tisha.
Keisha. Her name's Keisha.
Yeah, Keisha. And I didn't know you liked her like that.
It's nothing. Just forget about it.
I know how you feel. I remember this one time when I was 6. Man, this girl broke my heart. Wouldn't give me the time of day.
Can you believe this? I'm being given advice about women by my little brother.
Don't worry. You'll be all right.
Oh, if you want, I could hook you up with Shanice.
Shanice? She's 16.
She'll make you forget all about Kiki.
Keisha. Name's Keisha.
Right. Keisha.
I sucked at every sport I tried.
Listen, I need a favor. Huh? I got on the basketball team, and I need to learn how to play by tomorrow.
The basketball team? Man, are you crazy? You know you don't know how to play.
Didn't I say that? I just need to know enough to look like I know something.
You know how to faint?
You mean, like, fake somebody up?
No, I mean, like, fall down and bang your head on the ground so you won't have to play.
Sorry about the game, man.
Should have fainted like I told you.
My brother Drew loved karate, and he didn't take lessons. All he had to do was see somebody do something, and then he could copy it. Today, you call that a music producer.
Chris! Breathe! Breathe!
What are you doing?
Practicing karate.
What are you gonna do with karate?
Shush your hand, Mom.
What?
It's thank you, Mom, in Chinese.
When my brother got into something, he got into it. You know, he's getting Asian girls to this very day.
Can I use that Chinese robe you used to wear?
Sure, what for?
I want to be a samurai. And do you have anything I could use as a sword?
Boy, you are not taking a sword on the street.
Man, in Bed-Stuy, you could get in trouble just for pointing your finger.
Down the street, man, right down there.
Drop your weapon! You got no weapon? I got the weapon. My finger, man!
I hope you can make it. I'll see you later, Drew. I remember, don't tell anybody, okay?
Okay.
I knew Keisha had a crush on Drew, but that didn't stop me from liking her.
Who was that?
Lisa Patterson. They just invited me to some Halloween party.
You got invited to a party?
Yeah. I'm not going, though. I'm going trick-or-treating.
Drew was only 11, and as exciting as girls were, they still couldn't beat free candy.
Candy, candy, candy. Halloween candy. So what you kids got in the bags? Give it up to Sweet Tooth.
Why don't you leave us alone?
No, this is a little light. But I'm gonna give you kids a chance to make it right for old Sweet Tooth.
Give my sister her candy back now.
I was so glad Drew didn't have a soul.
Do I hear him back, though? No. Now, you kids, get the tricking and the treat. And you best to have all my candy.
Sweet Tooth died 2 years later of a bad case of gingivitis.
Mom, some pimp took all our candy.
What?
If I had my sword, it wouldn't have happened.
The martial arts.
Yeah, why? Yeah.
The only thing Drew loved more than candy was learning how to break a neck. Instead of watching the machines like I told them, Drew was perfecting the flying monkey death claw.
Ah! Man, what are you doing?
Were you able to get the clothes done?
We have a little problem. I told you not to put the colors in with the whites.
Mama's gonna kill me.
Hold on, I think I can fix this. Excuse me, miss.
Yes?
My brother put the colors in with the whites and now everything's pink. Could you please help us get the clothes back white again? Or my mother's gonna kill us.
Oh, I'd be happy to.
Thanks.
How'd you do that?
I don't know.
When Drew turned 18, that woman looked him up. Not to be a boyfriend, she just loved doing his laundry.
Wow. See? Whiter than they were when you brought them in.
Thanks. You want me to teach you a kill move?
No, that's okay. When you turn 18, you call me, okay?
Okay. Let's go get these in the dryer.
Chris did it.
Chris!
Chris isn't here.
Well, where is he?
I don't know.
Well, who put this pot on the stove?
Wasn't me.
Because of those two words, Drew never got in trouble.
Who tore up my back seat?
Wasn't me.
Who left my nickel laying out here on the sidewalk?
Wasn't me.
Who spilt this oatmeal?
Wasn't me.
Would you believe those were his first words?
Is Chris here yet?
Nope.
Who cut your doll's hair off?
Wasn't me.
What are y'all arguing about?
Nothing.
Drew said there's no such thing as Santa Claus.
What are you talking about, boy? Of course there's a Santa Claus, baby.
While Drew was showing Tanya something no kid should see.
See? I told you. Oh, cool!
Tanya, like Mommy told you, there is a Santa Claus.
So how come there's a room upstairs full of presents?
Who told you that?
Drew showed me.
Drew, get in here!
Yes, Mom?
Did you show Tanya the presents upstairs?
Yeah.
We need to talk.
Hold on, Mama. No. Wait.
My mother talked about beating us all the time. But the only time she ever beat us is when she said she wanted to talk. And she talked the hell out of Drew that night.